Thank you, Madam Chairwoman. Thank you for the for all the enlightenment. I'm just wondering, how long has Lifespan had such a policy in place, and how often is it amended?
We do a top-to-bottom review each year, so annually it's amended. It's to ensure that we're in compliance with any changes in the law and any internal processes that may have changed. We have had it, and we have mandated sexual harassment training for, I don't know the number of years off the top of my head, but it's been for quite some time, when in fact we didn't necessarily have to, but we felt it was that important that we have the annual compliance training that included the sexual harassment for all of our employees, and we've been doing that for many, many years.
I also have a couple questions on the types of offenses. Mm-hmm. Like, do you have a lot of offenses? Is it more often than not from a superior, and is it always man to a woman, or is it always, or does it fluctuate?
It does fluctuate, and I would say it is probably more often than not a power imbalance, but we do have peer-to-peer as well.
Because I mean, I could see where someone might be apprehensive to report a superior, but if you're on par, then you know, either you smack them in the mouth, and then you'd have no reservations about reporting it.
Well, you know, what we try to educate people about too is it's differing perceptions. What might be comfortable behavior to one person is very uncomfortable to others. So it's also that third party bystander intervention that we need to be aware of. So, you know, we challenge our employees and our leaders to really examine their own behavior and ensure that they're following our policy and the law.
Right, and I don't envy your industry, because I'm sure, you know, it's prone to this behavior probably more so than most industries. So thank you. Thank you, Madam Chairwoman.